Hi, I'm George, and I'll be showing you the things to check if your resource pack isn't working inside of Minecraft Java. Okay, first thing let's do, let's just get out of this game here and get back to this screen. Come down to the Options button right there and click on Resource Packs, and let's make sure that your resource pack is even showing up in the game. So check your list over here on the available resource packs and the list on your currently active resource packs and make sure that you're seeing your pack. If you're not seeing your pack in these two lists, then we need to go out and take a look at the folder which contains all of this stuff. There are two easy ways to get to that folder. One, of course, is right down here, Open Resource Pack Folder. Click on that, and there's your resource pack folder. There it is. Now, if you don't want to do that, the other way to get here is just to go up and get any window like this opened up, and then type in %appdata%, hit the Enter key. That takes you to this location. It's in the roaming folder right there. You'll see Minecraft here. Double click there and then resource packs right there. Double click that. Same place, same location. Easiest way though is just to click right there on that button and there's your resource packs. And here we go. Here's my resource pack folder, and that's all the resource packs I have in the game right now. The ones on the left-hand side and the right-hand side. So the first thing to check at this point is to make sure you're seeing that .zip at the end. If you're not seeing that, go up here to View, and then over here where it says File Name Extensions, make sure that that is checked. You need to see that .zip. Okay, if it says .zip, then that's okay. The next thing is to make sure that you have the pack.mcmeta file included in the zip. Let's just open up one of these, open that up, and make sure that this file is included inside of your zip file. It should have the assets and the pack.mcmeta. Those are the required ones, and it's also nice to have the pack.png. We'll talk about that in just a moment. So if this is in here, then make sure it has the correct format in there. I have one right back here. Here's the actual code for that pack.mcmeta file, and it needs to be format 5 if you're working in Minecraft 1.15 and later at this point. So make sure this is all correct. Now this can be on one line or on several lines. One line is the easiest. And also, this has to be saved in the ANSI format. Let me show you what that is. Go up to the File menu. I'll come down here to Save As. And right down here where it says Encoding, make sure that that says ANSI, the ANSI encoding format. If it's one of these other ones, it's not going to work. So double check that as well. Now, if you can't get it to open up like this in Notepad like I do, open a browser window so you can see your file in the browser window. Right-click on it. And then in the list in here, pop-up list, go to Open With, and then choose Default Program, and then search down here to find the one you want to use. I have mine set for Notepad. You can click on this and open up, you know, all kinds of programs in there. Again, the one that I like using is Notepad. It's just easy to use on these pack.mcmeta files. Okay, so that's all taken care of. So we check that, and it has the right format number in there, and it's also in that ANSI format as well. So if that's correct, this should then work for you just fine. Most of the problems I've seen with resource packs not working is those two things. It not being in the .zip format, and it doesn't have the pack.mcmeta file. If you fix those two things, chances are it's going to be just fine. The next thing I want to show you is if the icon doesn't show up properly. Let me bring back up Minecraft. There we are, and these all have custom icons, as you can see. I'll scroll down. One of these doesn't, and that's this one right down here. This has the default image on that. That's the pack.png file right there. So if you don't have that pack.png file, you're just going to get this grayscale block. If you want to have this look a lot more interesting, then you need to have that pack.png file. It's real easy. Let me bring that up again. There's my pack.png, my standard one. And there's the image, as you can see. And it's simply a 256 by 256 file, and it's just called pack.png. Aside from that, it can be anything that you want inside here. It doesn't matter. Just 256 by 256, and it's just named pack.png. And as long as that's inside of your resource pack, you'll then get that custom icon. Okay, let's say that you can't find the jar file or the assets folder. Let me show you where those are. Easiest way to do this is to go up here, and let's just go back to our home page. There we are. And then type in %appdata and %. Let's open that up. Here we go. At the top of your list, it should say Minecraft right there. Ignore those two. Those are for beta versions. So here's my regular running Minecraft. Go inside here, and right down there, there's your resource packs folder right here. Now, if you're looking for the jar file, keep on going further down, and it's down here where it says versions. Go into this folder, and here are all the different versions for your different copies of Minecraft, and look for your current version. That's my current version right there. Down below this I have some of the beta snapshots in here, things like that. I also have my fabric loader right down there, and up here someplace I have Optifine, there we go, and there's Forge. So I have those in here as well, but this is what I'm currently running with right there. That's the one that you want. Open that up, and you should see two files, a .json and a .jar. The .jar is the one that you want. And again, if you're not seeing those extensions, if you don't see .jar and you don't see .json, go up to View and make sure that File Name Extensions is checked right there. You'll then see the .jar, and that's the file you'll want to use. That's your basic file. Now, another problem that people occasionally get is that they try to fix this right inside of this jar file. Don't do that. Make sure you copy this off to a different location. Let's say I wanted to put this over here someplace. I'll stick it in here. Doesn't matter where it goes, just someplace different. Right click, drag, copy. There you go, there's my copy, and there it is. I can now open it up here, and then it's going to be fine. My computer will be safe. The one thing you don't ever want to do is never, ever open this up on your desktop. That's going to crash your computer. So never, ever open it up on your desktop. Always put it into some folder someplace. I just made a folder on my computer that I call Minecraft, and I stuck it over here, and I'll work with it in here. And you can use any program you want that works with zip files to open this thing up. I'll just right-click on this. I can open up mine with either 7-zip that I have on here, or I also have WinRAR, I can use that one as well. Either one works out just fine. This is actually just a zip file. If you don't have any of those programs, you can just go in here and backspace right there and type in .zip. And now it's going to open up as a regular zip file. Let me just show that. I'll double click on that. Opens it up. There you go. So it's that easy. You don't even have to use a program to open it up. You will have to use a zip program to re-zip this for your final output, and I always like using 7-zip for all this stuff, but you don't actually have to have it for this first initial step. You can just change that name down there and you're fine. Okay, when you go inside of the jar file, the one folder you want is that one right there. It says assets. You can delete everything else. Nothing else is needed. That's all you need right there. Something else that can really help if you're having problems still and your pack is just not working right, one more thing you can do is you can optimize your resource pack. And that's when you're working your assets and you're working here inside of Minecraft and you're in the textures down here. You can delete everything else. You only need to include the things you're actually working on. Let's say you're just working on blocks. Let's open up textures. The blocks are right up here. I could delete everything else and just keep that one. And this is going to run just fine. Let me go back and show you real fast in Minecraft. There we go. I currently only have 3 resource packs installed. I have my spacesuit. This only has the spacesuit on it. It's nothing else, just that one image, the one spacesuit image. My custom banners only has banners in it. And my paintings only has paintings in it. The reason that this works is that Minecraft first loads the bottom resource pack. It then loads the next one up the stack and replaces anything from here that's in here. In this case, it replaces just my spacesuit. It then opens up the next pack and it replaces the custom banners on top of this. It then opens up the next pack and replaces those items on top of this. So it reads from the bottom to the top, and all you actually need in here are just the files that you have replaced. On the left-hand side over here, I have my sounds file right here. Here is my, or one of my records files. There's my main records file right over here. And this only includes just the music records, just the CDs. That's all that has. So that also can really help on making sure that your pack is nice and clean and tight, and that will really help to make it run properly. Now I have a video on how to optimize your resource pack, and I'll put a link for that right up there, upper right hand corner, so you can go ahead and take a look at that. All right, that should help you solve any problems you're having with your resource pack. Check the description. I'll have timestamps in the description for all of those different steps in there. And also, take a look at my playlist, upper right-hand corner right up there, to find more great Minecraft videos. I have a new playlist I just set up there with all this customization stuff in that playlist. And don't forget to click on like and share and subscribe as well. And I'll see you next time.